Good evening. Thank you all so much for joining us tonight for a special performance of the Sheboygan Symphony Holiday Brass. I'm Josh Herndy, and I'm privileged to serve as the Executive Director of your Sheboygan Symphony. Before we get underway with our program this evening, I want to take a moment to say thank you to our season sponsor, the Frank and Frieda Bratz Family Foundation, and to our season guest artist sponsor, Mr. Terry House. I also want to thank all of you. This year has been absolutely devastating for arts organizations around the world, and your generosity has been wonderful for the past several months. But we still need your help. Tonight's program, along with the rest of the programs this season, will be live streamed at no charge to you. This means that we will have no income from selling tickets, and we will be relying on your continued generosity to get us to our 103rd season. So, if you do find yourself in a position to give, we ask that you be as generous as possible. You can do so by visiting justgiving.com and typing in the Sheboygan Symphony, or head on over to either our website, our Facebook page, or Instagram page and follow the links there. Or, if you're the more traditional type like I am, you can mail a check directly to our office. If you have any questions, just give us a call. Speaking of our Facebook and Instagram pages, make sure that you like or subscribe to them and also sign up for our email list through our website so you can be kept up to date on everything that's going on. We have some exciting news about the rest of our season and about our organization as a whole coming out just after the new year, and believe me, you don't want to miss it. Tonight, we will be having an intermission, and it'll be about 10 minutes long. So, stretch your legs, visit the restroom, refill your drinks and your snacks, and then get settled back in for the second half. Lastly, before we get started, if you must travel this holiday season, please do so safely and responsibly. We want to see each and every one of you in person at our concerts as soon as we can, and that won't be possible unless we all work together. But wherever you are, whatever you're doing, and whomever you're with, we hope that you have kindness and love in your heart and a merry tune in your ear. From all of us at your Sheboygan Symphony, happy holidays and enjoy the program.
Thank you. Thank you very much for coming to the concert this evening online. It's such strange times we live in here, isn't it? But we're delighted that you decided to join us at the Sheboygan Symphony for our holiday brass concert. The first tune you heard, of course, was Adeste Fidelis, or O Come All You Faithful. And in fact, you are the faithful who have come to support the Sheboygan Symphony in this time, and we're delighted to have you here. We're going to perform for you a variety of different music tonight with a lot of different styles, all in the holiday mood. My name is Mike Forbes, and I'll be your conductor, and also I'm going to talk a little bit about each piece so you can kind of hear where the pieces are coming from and sort of what to expect. The next work we're going to perform for you is called Russian Christmas Music, and it was written by Alfred Reed back in 1944. Right at the end of World War II, it was decided that we should try to repair some relationships with Russia. And in fact, this piece was written under that, commissioned under that idea. And in fact, Alfred Reed wrote this piece in just 16 days before the premiere. It was originally written for symphonic band and is based on four different Russian tunes that they would use during the Christmas time. And while the symphonic band piece is about 20 minutes long, this version you're about to hear has been condensed to just 6 minutes, but still hits on those four main melodies. So I hope you enjoy Alfred Reed's Russian Christmas Music.
Thank you.
Hope you enjoyed a little Russian Christmas music. Now we're going to continue a little bit further to the west and explore some European carols. Three, as a matter of fact. The first European carol that we're going to explore is from England, Cornwall, actually, in the southwest of England. And this carol comes to us from the 1800s. And of course, the First Noel is its title, and you'll know it very well. We're going to combine these three into this medley. So the second carol you're going to hear is probably one of the oldest ones. And this one comes from Gregorian chant, or plain song, written somewhere between 800 and 900 AD, and then sort of revised into sort of a harmonic sound in the 1200s in France. And it's called Veni, Veni, Emmanuel, or O Come, Emmanuel. You'll know that one well. Very old carol, I must say. And the third carol comes from Catalan, Spain, Catalonia, actually, in Spain. And this carol comes from the 1600s and is called Fum, 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 which is the sound you'll hear in the piece as you would play it on a guitar, fum, 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 at the end of the phrase. And in this carol in particular, I think it's good to note that carols were meant originally to be danced to, and then eventually we added words and we would sing Christmas carols. But in fact, the most intent of a carol was at first to dance, and I think you'll really capture that in the Catalan carol, fum, 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 at the end. So I hope you enjoy the First Noel, Veni, Veni, Emmanuel, and Fum, Fum, Fum. Thank you. I assume a number like that just wants to, you just want to get up and dance like you should to a carol. And somewhere out there after that tune, I think I heard a roaring sense of applause from everyone who's tuned in tonight. So I appreciate that. Thank you. It's a bit strange to play such arousing music and to hear nothing after the end of it, but that is the way it is in 2020. So thank you again for joining us. That was Fum Fum Fum, the last of a three carol medley. We're going to continue now with our final piece for this half of the program. Then we're going to take a 15-minute intermission, but please join us for the second half, which is going to be more pops-oriented, a lot of jazz numbers, and more poppy charts from the holidays. This is next piece, The Festive Cheer, is going to give you a little bit of an appetizer for what you're about to hear in the second half. This medley involves a couple of really famous tunes that you're, of course, going to know and love, and it's just wonderfully set in this arrangement by Roger Harvey. The first tune, of course, is the infamous Sleigh Ride by Leroy Anderson. And you're going to hear all kinds of different whips and slaps of the horses. You're going to hear a whinny at the end, the whole shebang, it's there. The next is a beautiful setting of Have Yourself a Very Merry Christmas. And the third tune in there is Jingle Bells, of course. And this is going to feature a percussion section back there. They're going to be juggling all kinds of instruments. And if you are, you know, able to watch that through the cameras there, you'll see the percussion running around like mad, trying to cover all the different percussion in the Jingle Bells. And finally, the last will end with We Wish You a Merry Christmas, very fitting for the end of this half. And again, please join us in 15 minutes after this number ends for the pop side of our concert in the second half of the program. Thank you. Festive cheer. Thank you. We're ready to go.
Count to three and go. Welcome back to the Sheboygan Symphony Holiday Brass Concert. This is the second half of the program, which is going to feature works that are much more popular in vein. We started right away with the 12 Days of Christmas, which we actually call, well, for those of you who have a good ear, you may have noticed that we went chromatically through all 12 keys. Each day was in a different key. So that was the 12 keys of Christmas for us. And the other cool thing is we have 12 different instrumentalists up here on stage, or 12 different parts, I should say. And each of those 12 parts got to show off a little bit, including the 12th one, 12 Drummers Drumming. You heard it back there by Jonathan, just a great job on the drum kit. That was a fun new arrangement that I just created this past year for this group.
and we had a lot of fun with that one. So we're going to continue now with a tune that comes from a Broadway musical, MAME, and it was with a tune is called "We Need a Little Christmas," and it comes in the Broadway show after the stock market crash of in October of 1929, and they're getting ready for Christmas, and the idea is, boy, we need a little Christmas after that stock market crash. Well, if there ever were a year where we need a little Christmas, I think 2020 is it. So, hope you enjoy. We Need a Little Christmas. That was "We Need a Little Christmas," of course made famous by Johnny Mathis. Translates pretty well to brass, and I gotta say, works really well sort of as a polka, especially here in Sheboygan. We're huge in Sheboygan. We're gonna continue now with something that I know my family loves to do this time of year, and that's watch Christmas TV specials. And one of the ones that you can't go without is a Charlie Brown Christmas, of course. And perhaps one of the most iconic tunes from that is this wonderful tune called "Christmas Time Is Here." And it's such a beautiful tune in that it has this sort of harmony that's very melancholy, very similar to Charlie Brown. And I think this piece really kind of captures that spirit of sort of a rainy day Christmas. It's going to feature a trombone solo in the middle by Jason Sobranek. I hope you enjoy "Christmas Time Is Here."
Thank you.
That was Christmas Time Is Here, featuring Jason Sobranek on a trombone solo there. We're going to shift over and feature now our trumpeters in the back row there in a tune that doesn't really have anything to do with the holidays. It's called Bugler's Holiday, and it's by Leroy Anderson, who gave us Sleigh Ride, of course. But this tune doesn't have anything to do with Christmas or the holiday season. But it has the word holiday in it, and it gets to feature some brass players. So we thought, why the heck not? I hope you enjoy Bugler's Holiday. Leroy Anderson's Bugler's Holiday. Such fun to play that tune any time of year. We're going to move on now to a work that's not going to include the trumpets. They need a well-earned break. There's a lot of high notes to play in this concert, as you have probably heard. And they're going to take a little break on this next tune. We're going to feature our low brass section and our horns in a beautiful arrangement of It Came Upon a Midnight Clear. And just to make it even more special, around this time of year, it's not uncommon, if it weren't 2020 and we didn't have the COVID crisis, it's not uncommon to see a lot of tuba and euphonium and baritone players out and about in the malls, in the state capitol in Madison, doing what's called a tuba Christmas, where they play a bunch of tuba Christmas carols, and there's usually not just, you know, a couple of them, but actually close to 100 sometimes tuba and euphonium players honking out Christmas carols, and for better or worse, it's a great spectacle. Well, this tune, to pay homage to that, we're going to be dropping our trombones and picking up a euphonium. So we've got three euphoniums and the tuba, and then the French horns are going to join us for a full-blown conical brass choir in our tribute to Tuba Christmases Everywhere and in this beautiful arrangement of It Came Upon a Midnight Clear. Thank you. That was our tribute to Tuba Christmases Everywhere. That was It Came Upon a Midnight Clear. We're going to move on now to a completely different style and a completely different climate. Here in Wisconsin, we all kind of got our first real taste of winter with a whole bunch of inches of snow we woke up to this morning. It's great. It puts us in the Christmas mood and the holiday mood, and in fact, it hopefully will stick around here all the way through Christmas. We can all have a white Christmas. That is not this tune, though. This is a very green Christmas. This is the Hawaiian version of Christmas, Mele Kalikimaka, Maka, and of course made popular by Bing Crosby and the Andrews Sisters. Of course, my generation, I didn't really grow up with Bing Crosby, although I enjoy him a lot now. We grew up, however, with a movie by Chevy Chase called Christmas Vacation. And in Christmas Vacation, Chevy Chase has a dream sequence where he envisions putting in a swimming pool in the summer. And of course, it's a holiday movie, so they use Mele Kalikimaka as the background music, and it's a very iconic scene. Really grabs you. So that's, I think, one of the best ways, again, to remember this tune. We're going to feature on bass trombone, playing the part of Bing Crosby, Jeremiah Ice. Hope you enjoy Mele Kalikimaka. That was Mele Kalikimaka, a Hawaiian way of saying Merry Christmas, made famous, of course, by Bing Crosby and the Andrews Sisters, portrayed here by bass trombonist Jeremiah Ice. We're going to continue now with, there aren't too many Christmas tunes that are, I would consider, sultry or even sexy, but this one is. This one's called Santa Baby, of course, made popular by Eartha Kitt, and this one's going to feature all kinds of members of the band, but especially our flugelhornist, Brian Haynes, in the back row over here. And I hope you enjoy this really fun big band rendition of Santa Baby. That was Santa Baby featuring Brian Haynes on flugelhorn. Well, we've really enjoyed performing for you tonight. If only you know how much it means to us to finally be back up on stage, even though we're performing for an empty concert hall. It's a beautiful concert hall, but it is empty. But we're imagining you in these seats, and I'm sure you're imagining yourself here. And we're really glad that you got a chance to tune in and watch this and listen to this wonderful performance that these folks are giving here in the Sheboygan Symphony Brass. Just a wonderful chance for us again to get together and do what we love to do, and that is bring so much hope and cheer in through music to all of you. So I hope you've enjoyed listening to this. We're gonna finish with one last number. This is my arrangement of Frosty, the Snowman, and I think it's just a great way to kind of finish this wonderful holiday concert. Features a lot of different people throughout the show, but in particular, Jonathan back there on the drum set again. Hope you enjoy Frosty, and thanks again for tuning in. Well, normally you would be here going crazy. I know it. I can hear it. I can actually hear it. So we're going to do one more tune for you, a built-in encore, if you will. And, you know, with 2020 being the way it is, we just felt, boy, that's a nice hot number, Frosty. It's a lot of fun to play that one. It's really exciting. But maybe it'd be a better idea to end off a little bit more sort of melancholy and hopeful for the future. And there's no better tune that I can think of than Mel Torme's The Christmas Song. Let's have some chestnuts roasting on the open fire. We're going to feature again Brian Haynes on flugelhorn and Jason Sobranek on trombone. I hope you enjoy this final tune from us tonight. Thanks again for tuning in. Enjoy Mel Torme's The Christmas Song.